Good day together. On behalf of Wittner and Hölscher, allow me to extend a warm welcome to you. First, let me introduce myself. My name is Andrew Heckmann, and I'm with the IT department of Wittner and Hölscher. I work as an IT process manager. Therefore, I'm responsible for logistics in the main part, and also for purchasing and for manufacturing in the processes and in the implementation in SAP. First, I'd like to give you a brief breakdown of our company and its products and its goals, and then I will give you a brief introduction into our S/4HANA migration project. So the agenda in this form, the introduction of our company, the road to implementation approach, our project overview and the expense overview, also the lessons learned, which we would like to share with you, and then one of our main goals of the implementation of S/4HANA, the now ongoing EWM implementation. Wittner & Hölscher is a traditional company founded in 1869. We are a healthy growing company. Worldwide company, we have employees worldwide, 3,137 in 2019. We are a machinery manufacturer. We are specialized in flexible packaging. We have extrusion, printing, and converting. Therefore, we give every solution in our market. As I said, we are a positive long-term growth company. Our sales grow faster than our employees. We are worldwide distributed. Our market is not concentrated on Europe or America. We are divided worldwide. And the worldwide shares are different every year. What do we offer? We offer quite everything around our products, from the consulting to the machines. We have a technology center where you can test your own products on our machines. We offer training and education in using our machines, also in producing products on our machines. And even services and upgrades on our machines. Digital solutions are the last innovations where we are offering digital products. This is an overview of our portfolio of machineries, which we are offering. And these are the products that most people know, which are where our machines are used to produce. Now to the main part, the road to our S/4HANA implementation. First, we were on a sub-innovation day on 2016. There are new products from SAP were introduced, and we got to know S/4HANA a little better. We got to know what was the strategy from SAP. And so we said we need a preliminary study. We need to know what is to be done. Can we do it? Is it the right time? And what does it offer? So we started a study in 2016. It was about 4 months. We checked, is it technically possible? We checked, are the processes we are using, are they are inside S/4HANA? Because it was a first release. And we checked the expected costs, and we had a large project in our company. It was a logistics project. We wanted to implement EWM, and we checked, what do we do? EWM in a separate system, in S/4HANA, it was included. So these were the first steps. Second steps, we tried the evaluation of the implementation timeline. we got into commercial final negotiations and we checked which are the risks and what are opportunities. In November 2016, we got a decision. We said, yes, we want to implement S4HANA. And we said, we take a scenario 1+3. It takes about 1 year of technical migration. We had a technical migration, a part of brownfield, not a greenfield. There were no reorganization of processes and best practices. We said we make a technical migration and then on this concluded 3 years reorganization. So to get the best out of the system, but a fast migration. And we decided to use the embedded EWM. Therefore, the logistics project was kept on hold until the migration was ready. The implementation timeline was started in September 2017, and the go-live was in November 2018. The project overview. The main project parties were SAP as implementation partner. It was a decision because it was an early release. We started on the 1610 version, but we went live on the 1709. And it were many problems and many not ready functions inside the system that we are using so that we decided to take SAP as the implementation partner to minimize the risk and get a commitment that they will do everything to make our processes run in the system. Our service provider for the infrastructure were all included, partners in the extended workbench and the SAP development system. We have add-ins, we have partners like Westernaha, which support us in many consulting decisions in programming in multiple ways. And we had our key users of all technical areas. Key users is to be meant in all our divisions in Windmüller and Hölscher. We have key users and they were all participating into this project. And nevertheless, our IT department. What was our implementation timeline? We set from September 2017 to November 2018. And we said, what is our main goal? Our main goal is a technical implementation, but we also need to know what comes after. We said 1+3. So we decided to make make delta workshops to look what are we doing in our ERP system on the ECC level. And what is the S4HANA simplification approach? In the meantime, we started with custom code adjustments. There were many custom code adjustments which could be made in the ECC system without migration, and there were some which could only be made after we've made the first migration of the first developing system. So these were the first parts. Afterwards, we were with the first transition. And after the first transition, we also looked for quick wins, which are out of the Delta workshops, where we said, yes, so these are the low-hanging fruits which we can implement. We had two test phases. And afterward, the pre-production, where we made a test run of our migration, and then we got our go live. So the migration planning workshops were the first which we did with SAP. And this is also really recommended to do. There were many things that are changed. There are FECO tables that are merged. There are technicals which are merged into material. There are the customer vendor integration that is new. There are many things on the technical level on the HANA database. So we got many things out of that. What we have to look out for, which are the problems that they know and what could we do? The main part integrated was FECO, because there were the most, there was a most hits in problems. We got preparatory workshops in all our key user circles. It was a warm up for our company, because we said it's not an IT project, it's a company project, and the departments themselves must say, yes, we want S/4HANA, not the IT says, new system, take it, it's cool. No, it must be a approach for the company, and we did it because of goals in the future. Then we had migration planning workshops a little bit deeper. We got a comparison of our processes, the best practices. We had fit gap workshops. They were terminated after a few workshops, and we had to realign our project team from SAP. We needed really good technical consultants, and we made a new staff inside the project team. Then there were new Delta workshops, and they supported by these new consultants, where we had our first quick wins. We had more than 55 workshops in this Delta scenario, where we found many approaches to simplify our system and get better into the S/4HANA simplification system. There were necessary development process adjustments that are, for example, production versions, customer vendor integration, MRP areas, and many more. So we started. We made many conversions on the way to our live system. We had 9 conversions. And the first 7 conversions every time failed. There were many, many problems. The runtime was too long. We had problems with parallel export and import of data. Tables were corrupted. Data was reporting. We had many problems. Most problems in FE. This was because of different ledger currencies which we used. But nevertheless, the 8th and 9th conversion worked, and we had our timeline, we were in time, but it was really hard work in the FE sector. What were our expenses? Our custom code analysis showed that we had 1.5 million lines of custom code. We had approximately 23,000 hits of needed adaptions, and 1,200 of them were really relevant. So there were no knockout points. Everything could be adapted. We had an estimated effort of about 1,000 hours. The custom code changes and the adaption showed to be the less problem. We had support from Westernacher. We had, had support from our own people inside our IT department. This really was not the problem. The problem were the adaptations of functions that were not available anymore. We had approximately 15 man days per ZAC user that are from our departments during the course of the project. Our SAP developers in our IT department were working at 100% capacity for this project and ongoing maintenance in the old system. There were no more developments in the old system and no more other projects, IT, including the SAP developers. Outside the SAP system, we still made projects and we still made new solutions. We had 1 to 2 days of training per SAP users, which we planned. Lessons learned. There we have some pain points. The customer vendor integration. It was really a high effort. It was not transparent in any way. We inside the vendor integration, and we didn't really know what will happen. There was hardly any advice from SAP. the tools from SAP were quite faulty. Nevertheless, it did work, but it was a hard time. Inside the SD, also the foreign trade was no more there. So we needed to find a function to use foreign trades inside S4HANA without SAP add-ons, because we had another add-on, and there we found it's quite challenging for our partner with a quite new product from SAP. And this was also a really, really hard time. Yes, function and table contents in the mission were really we had some corrupt data, we had some corrupt problems. So the customer vendor integration was really a problem from HR to SD to MM for purchasing, for the vendor, for the customer, but also for our own personal data, where some in our early release, which we used, the tools had problems in integrating the HR data. But nevertheless, it worked. We had the conversion on the basis release 17.09. This was also a problem because you couldn't direct update to a feature package. Many problems which occurred in the customer vendor integration were in the feature package 1. They were no more. So we had hundreds of clues that we had to be played in. And this is hard work. This is many testing time. And therefore, we had many problems in getting this to work. We had production versions, which we didn't use before, but you get no dependent requirements of assemblies without a production version. So we needed to bring this really quick in. So we had this as a black spot. We didn't knew, there is something you have to integrate, and the production versions that we hadn't on screen for us. And we had a real problem with OSS message processing. It was, in our view, it was inadequate. Hardly any processing of any reports we pushed to SAP that were not classified high or very high, because our system was not a production system, because we were inside a migration. And so we had the problems in our qualification assurance on our development system. And therefore, you had to push every single report that they get into a work. But in our project, we found a way with SAP to communicate, to bring this up, and to bring our system in a focus. But nevertheless, it was not a productive system. Then we had the problem where the customer orientation level of training could be improved at SAP. We had long discussions until problems were really understood. We had often no understanding. It was really in the bomb materials. We had the bill of materials. We had problems with the customer vendor integration, and we had the impression we were not understood. This was better to the end of the project. It was a learning process, and nevertheless, it's lessons learned, but it did work in the end. It was a hard way on this approach. And lessons learned, archiving. Archiving is a key point to an S4 integration. Our system had any data from 2002 to 2018. So we had a mass of database. And with the archiving, we had really less for the conversion. So the conversion went really smoother and it went really faster. But there are problems with residence times for the material ledger vouchers. So archiving is a key point, but it must be started before an S4HANA implementation. We had an infrastructure challenge. because of being really one of the first and because of our history of using EBM infrastructure, we had one of the first EBM power infrastructures that were licensed for S/4HANA. So we had really a challenge to bring this infrastructure to work. We had the changeover inside our company from AIX to Linux. We had completely new backups procedures. We had a complete changeover of our print servers. It all worked, but this was really a challenge. And from our lessons learned, this was something of an early adopter where we had to be to put more power in, more peoples, more resources. We had the right partners. We had the knowledge from our partner, but we had too few people inside our company on this point. Now, the main goal we wanted to achieve is the implementation of EWM afterwards. So this was a part of our Logistics 4.0 project program, and we decided to make the embedded EWM integration. We replaced some non-SAP solutions, which were individual programmed by Windmill and Hölscher on a non-SAP system. And we had the warehouse management system from Westernacher, which is used for our automatic warehouse. And everything together we wanted to put into an integrated EWM in the S/4HANA system. Service logistics is productive. Shipping of new machines is also productive in our company. These were pain points because we had some special processes which were not in the EWM standard, but it was easier to implement into an integrated EWM because we had all access to data of the ERP and the EWM. And we could integrate it much easier. And the connection from EWM integrated to the ERP inside the S/4HANA is much more direct than the extended warehouse management on a separate machine. What were our goals or benefits we want to achieve into this EWM implementation? Our benefits first were that we had direct integration into the ERP system. We have smoothed out workload. We had increased transparency across the whole warehouse plant. We have everything into one system from the ERP to the EWM, from the warehouse to the ERP system. We had efficient business processes which are built in the system in standard. The dialogues are user-friendly because our users are used to use SAP also in the warehouse department, and so they had it easier to adapt to an EWM than to another system that was not of the same look and feel. And they had the easy approach that they find every data from the ERP in the EWM system. And it's a state-of-the-art technology in warehouse management. So, to come to the end, even though I talked about problems, we were very satisfied with the course of the project. And that is really, we are now running S/4HANA on the release 19.09. And we learned that the first approach to 17.09, the implementation, was hard work. But afterwards, the updates from one to another version are much more easier. And if you are one inside the S/4HANA, it's like a little bit like feature packages, which are also, or enhancement packages, which were installed in the ECC system. So we are really, we are satisfied with the outcome. We have an EWM integrated, which is working in parts, and the rest is going live at the end of this year. We are using Fury apps in some parts. We use special functions now from the 1909 system inside our purchasing department, and so on. We are setting up a new process development and process organization inside W&H, where we also use many functions of the new S/4HANA system. That's the end of my presentation. If there are any questions to my presentation or you want to get into contact with me, my name is André Heckmann from Widmer & Deutscher, and I would be pleased to give you answers to my extent where I can. Thank you for your... sorry, no native English speaker. Sorry, thank you for your time.